Thinks Mark, a Tuolumne County State Park business is calling out a Bay Area company after they say their contactless payment system, Square, abruptly pulled the plug on their account.
So Square, you might know, is that portable credit card reader that's geared towards small businesses. The CEO is Jack Dorsey, who's also the co-founder of Twitter. KCRA3's Vicky Gonzalez took a trip to Columbia Historic State Park and learned that the shop believes this issue is a misunderstanding of replica firearms with few options to clear things up.
Just east of New Bolognese Lake is a gold rush town frozen in time.
You bet. Okay, 7502.
And the Sharps are all about committing to California's history.
Name of your business.
Columbia Booksellers and Variety Store.
The building standing since 1854. And the town preserved with California State Parks.
Of course, all of the shops and the merchants that are here operate as concessions for the state park.
But last month, the Sharps abruptly closed their doors after the credit card operator, Square, deactivated their account.
We received an email, kind of a boilerplate email from Square that says that our account is being deactivated. We're baffled. Rosanna's getting ready to go to work, and I open my email and realize we can't open today.
Just flat out. No explanation, nothing, and just cut off.
When rereading the terms, the only item that came to the Sharp's mind, the sale of firearms.
What we have in the case are non-firing, non-operable replicas of 18th and 19th century firearms. None of these can be modified to fire a live round. They are really just expensive toys, is what they are.
Columbia Booksellers and Variety Store is contracted with California State Parks. State Parks confirms not only are the Sharps in compliance, they also confirm that functional weapons of any kind are not allowed. What is allowed? Merchandise that reflects the period of history. Collector's items.
When they deactivated our account, we could not take credit card payments. We have reached out on numerous occasions with Square. They've been unresponsive.
The Sharps reopened after they found a new credit card operator, estimating $4,000 in losses.
They're treating us with contempt as if we've done something wrong. But I feel like if they would have picked up the phone and just called us, a five-minute phone conversation would have cleared this whole thing up.
Square declined an interview, and they would not provide a statement. At Columbia State Historic Park in Tuolumne County, Vicky Gonzalez, KCRA 3 News.
Okay, so you heard Vicky say Square declined to talk about this specific case, but the company said, generally speaking, existing customers have numerous ways to contact their team, including phone and email. However, we were unable to find what communications options are available once an account has been deactivated.